In this video, we will discuss how files can be handled using Python. Whenever we are developing applications that requires handling large amounts of input-output data, in that case, files are more convenient than using the variables. So actually, Python supports several built-in functions. So that supports various file handling operations like creation, reading, updating, and deletion. And in Python, we need not to import any package or module to use the file-related functions. Let's start our discussion by understanding how Python supports reading the contents from the files. Let's try to implement some code to read the contents from the given file. Before applying any operations, it is required to open the file, and Python supports the open method, which allows you to open the file before applying any operations onto the file. The open method takes two string arguments, where the first argument indicates the file you would like to open, and the second argument indicates the mode in which you are opening the file. That is, whether you would like to read from the file or write into the file, or what is the type of operations you are going to apply, that can be indicated by the second argument. So here you can observe the first argument I am passing is the sample.txt. Here in this case, I would like to open the file sample.txt, and I'm going to read the content from the file. So the mode of the file must be R. So here R stands for read mode. Whenever the file that is being opened is existing in the same directory as the script you are executing, then it is enough to pass the file name alone. And if it is in a different directory, then it is required to pass the entire path of the file name. Say for example here, the file I would like to open is a sample.txt file, and so the script file I am run is stored in the file files_sample1.py. In my case, both files are not in the same directory, then it is required to pass the entire path to open the file. So here you can observe the entire path of the file is passed along with the file name. So to open any file, you need to use the open method. The first argument must be the file name, and the second argument is the mode in which you are opening the file. And this open method returns a file pointer. The file pointer allows you to do various operations later after opening the file. So here in this case, the file pointer is stored in the variable fp. This file pointer is also known as a file handler, which allows you to perform the read, write, or other operations on the file. Now the file sample.txt is opened in the read mode, and the file pointer is stored in the variable fp. So now we can apply the read operations. To read the contents from files, Python supports various operations like read, read lines, and read line. So let's see how we can use each of these functions one by one. The read method allows you to read specific number of bytes. This function takes one integer argument, which specifies the number of characters that you would like to read from the file. In this example, I am passing the value 15, which indicates I would like to read 15 characters from the current file pointer in the file sample.txt. And the content that is read from the file is returned by this read method. So in this case, I am storing that value in the variable s. Whatever the contents that are stored in the variable s, that I am displaying onto the standard output device using the print method. And now the read operation is done. So here we opened the file using the open method. Then we are reading the contents from the file using the read method. Now the processing is done. So once the file operations are done, then it is your responsibility to close the file. Close the file, Python supports the close method. So you just use the close method along with the file pointer, whichever the file you would like to close. On executing this close method, what happens is all the resources that are allocated for this file will be released. So that it is very important to close the file once the operations are done on the opened file. Now let's execute this code and see. So if you observe the contents of the file sample.txt, you can see there are few lines of text that is available in the sample.txt file. Now let's run this code and see. You can observe that the first 15 characters from the file are read and returned by using the read method, and the same has been displayed using the print method. And finally, after applying all the operations at the end, the file is being closed using the close method. So that is how you can use the read method to read specific number of bytes from the file. When you do not pass any argument to this read method, then what happens is the entire contents of the file is read and will be returned by the read method. Let's do not pass any argument to the read method and see what happens. So here you can observe that all the contents of the file sample.txt are being read and returned by the read method. That is how when you do not pass any argument to the read method, then the entire contents of the file will be read. Python supports another method which allows you to read a single line of text from the file. You can use a read line method to read a specific line, that is from the current file pointer position till the end of that line. The entire line will be read and will be returned by the read line method. So now let's execute this code and see. So you can observe that, so one single line of text is read from the file sample.txt and is returned by the readLine method. Now let's extend this to one more line and see what happens. So here in this code, we opened the file using the open method. We opened for reading, and then we are reading the first line of text from the file using the readLine method. Then we displayed that content, and again we read the next line, and then we displayed that content also. And finally, after applying all the operations, the file is being closed. Now let's execute this code and see. Here you can observe that the first line is read and then the second line, because we used two different readLine statements to read the different lines from the file. So that is how. So readLine method supports reading of a single line. That is, from the current file pointer till the end of the line, it allows you to read the data from the file. In addition to the read and read line method, Python also supports one more method to read the contents from the file. So that is read lines. The read lines method reads the entire contents of the file and returns the contents of the file as a list, and each line of the file becomes one element in the list. Now let's run this code and see. So here you can observe that the entire content of the file is being read, where the element that is returned is a list, where every element in this list is a string, so where each string is a line from the file. So that is how Python supports the read lines method to read the entire contents of the file as a list. Once the file is opened, it is also possible to iterate over every line of the file. We can use a for loop along with the file pointer to iterate over the file. Here, if you observe, this for loop can be used to iterate over the file. So for S in FP. FP is a file pointer from which we are read the content from the file. S indicates a loop variable to which you are assigning the line of text that you are reading over the iterations. In this example, I'm just displaying the content that I'm reading in every iteration. Now let's run this code and see. So if you observe here, you can see every line of the file is read and it is displayed. So this is how you can use the for loop to iterate over every line of the file. So far we have seen how to open the file in the read mode. Then how to use various methods to read the contents from the file. You can use the read method to read specific number of bytes or characters by passing a specific integer to the read method, or you can use the read method without any passing an argument to read the entire contents of the file as a string, or you can use the read line method to read a specific line from the current file pointer till the end of that line, or you can even use the read lines method to read the entire contents of the file as a list. Thank you for watching this video.